Good innovative play there by Duncan Paiaua, who was playing fly half for the Queensland Reds. Has been playing in the centres for the under-20s. Very versatile. James Tuttle can play fly half as well. So big scrum here for the Australian team. No changes in the Australian lineup. Big push coming in from Samoa, but it's a penalty against them, and once again, almost in front of the posts. They're having a lot of problems at scrum time. It seemed to me that push was premature. Referee Houston having a word to the front row. Adams, Ilya and Tamoyeta. Penalty going Samoa's way. Just a free kick. Not a full penalty. So Ioane relieves the pressure. And finds touch successfully. Josh Ioane's played impressively for Samoa. Ned Hannigan, great take, and well picked up by James Tuttle onto Deegan. This is Kellaway crashing through, tackled by Winterstein. Out to Deegan, out to in the centres is Newsome, making the extra man from fullback. Deegan, a long pass out to McInerney, who's smashed to the ground by the big prop forward Tamoyeta. And it goes to Samoa. Australians pushing well in that scrum, and they've got possession on the ground. Yes, Tuttle gets it away to Deegan. A little kick angled across for the left wing coming through. Can Kellaway get the bounce? No, he can't. But it's Yasmin who's got it. Snaps it up and dives and scores. Christian Yasmin gets his second try. Beautiful work on the inside, especially by Deegan with that beautifully judged kick. And the bounce favoured Christian Yasmin.
14, Christian Yasmin. Second time he
makes it 28 points to 5 with the kick to come. That was better play by the Australian back line. Good option by Deegan. Judged it perfectly, and there's always a degree of luck with the bounce, I suppose, but a couple of players were there, Kellaway and Yasmin, and it was the winger who snapped it up and scored his second try. Deegan from the sideline. He's hit it well. And he's landed it. Oh, what a kick.
Conversion successful by
magnificent. Takes it to 30 points to 5. And Andrew Deegan's fourth successful kick out of 6 attempts. Brad Wilkin takes it, and he's tackled, I thought, in the air, but the referee said it was okay. That's McInerney, the hooker. Players in pods, supporting each other. Long pass from Deegan, finds Kellaway, running smoothly. He's a very elusive runner. The blind side, Tuttle linking up there with Jack Redden, but it's Tuttle still. Terrific run by the halfback. And eventually over the sideline. And quick throw in by Samoa. Tia Tia kicking downfield, kicks it out in the full. So we come back to where he kicked it. Johnny Samuelu is on number 22, who's a reserve winger on the left wing. Oh, good ball for Australia. Ned Hannigan getting possession. Deegan linking up out there with one of the flankers. Deegan, a little dummy, makes an incision, but not too far. Cover defence picking him up. Now that's Tyrrell Lomax, the big prop forward, crashing upfield. Wilkin, an Australian sevens player, very elusive, fast for a big fella. The ball's out, anybody's ball. Still Australia managed to keep possession. Tuttle, Lomax, under pressure. Recycled by the Australians, now Deegan. Kellaway in centre field. Well and truly wrapped up, and they'll try and keep him in the air, but he manages to get it down to ground. But still, it's a Samoan ball. Use it or lose it. Another replacement coming on. Number 19 is Potu Leavasa for Samoa, a lock or number 6. He replaces Ben Tuiomanafili, the lock, so he'll go into the second row. Scrum by Samoa this time. Kicked back behind Newsom. Has Jack Redden outside him, but elects to put it high. Redden following through. And well taken. Tia Tia to Iwani. It's a good run by the replacement Samuelu. Oh, knocked on. Change for the Australians, number 18 coming on, that's Ferretti Saaga, replacing Tyrrell Lomax, the loose head. And Ferretti Saaga is the heaviest man in the tournament at 128 kilograms. He's from Melbourne, Victoria. And I venture to say he's probably Samoan. Deegan, Kellaway. Nice straight running from the centre. Good support by the forwards. They work the blind side. Wilkin, Jack Redden. Plenty of pace, but a foot into touch. He scored, but he's put a foot over the sideline. No try. Touch judge Jeff Greg Milne putting the flag up, spotted Jack Redden, who would have loved to have got a meat pie for his birthday, 20 today. Good ball by Tapili going high. Lost. Now a quick chance for the Australians. Paiaua. Long pass intended for Redden, cut out two players, a little bit over ambitious. Tamatani feeds, and it's a penalty to Samoa. Still 15 metres inside Samoa's half. Junior Halafuka, replacement throwing in. Tapili, good ball. And nice passing by the backs. Tia Tia making the extra man. Good tackled ball and all by Kellaway. Wani almost coughed up, but managed to be controlled. Comes back to the flanker. That's Fatalainga. And it's a penalty Australia's way. A lot of mistakes creeping into the game in the second half. We saw such a clinical exhibition by New Zealand against Japan, beating them 75-0. Barely made a mistake in the whole game, New Zealand. They're very impressive. And that stamped them as tournament favourites. Here's a good kick by Deegan. So Australia with a... an ideal attacking springboard here. Connell McInerney throwing in. Ned Hannigan, good ball. The drive from the Australians. Still they have it. Driving it towards the line, but it's on the ground and it's been knocked forward. So a bit like what the Waratahs did to the Brumbies last night. They put on the drive and couldn't control it. It's very hard to defend, but they did it well. Not everyone has a Will Skelton who can reach over the whole pack and disrupt the ball. Mike Tamoyeta has spent more time on the ground than he has on his feet, I think. The tight head for Samoa. Built very low to the ground himself. Good ball this time. That's Winterstein. Bad pass. This is the new player, Samuelu. Knocked on. Samuelu looks to have a bit of pace about him, Johnny Samuelu, only a little fella, 165 centimetres tall, but he can scoot. He comes from Marist St. Joseph's Club in Apia West. Yasmin looming here, might be the first receiver off this scrum. A blind winger. Or perhaps he'd be looking for the inside pass from Deegan. Let's wait and see. The Australians have controlled their scrum pretty well. Square, perhaps going a little bit prematurely. Regardless, it's another penalty against the Australian pack. Ioane gains about 20 metres. Junior Halafuka throwing in. And Fetalinga is lifted but couldn't get it. Picked up by Pahiua for Australia. And lots of little errors have crept in the last few minutes. Halfway stage of the second half. Australia 30, leads Samoa 5. If you missed the earlier game, New Zealand were outstanding in having a clean sheet against Japan, 75-0. Scored 11 tries. So far, Australia has scored 3 tries to 1. I beg your pardon, 4. We've had 1 to Wilkin, 1 to Fakasilia, and 2 to Yasmin. 4 tries. Word here by referee Houston to Connell McInerney, the hooker for Australia. Plays for Tuggeranong in the ACT. whatever it is Samoa's doing in the scrums, it's disrupting the Australians, who were much more impressive in the first half. Physio Campbell Hansen is being kept busy for the Australians. He's a Kiwi, strangely enough. So Jonathan Taumatane to feed this scrum. A lot of time being spent on scrums in this match. Good strike that time by Elia. Tiatia makes the extra man. Good tackle, Kellaway. Put that Patafilo down. Another penalty to Samoa. They'll take the tap and go. That's Tiatia. Doesn't waste any time. Eventually put down by Ollie Camp. A relieving kick by Kellaway. Won't find touch. Poor kick. Ioane's kick. Looking to chase. And they grab Wilkin in possession, and he gets support. Now the Australians release it. Deegan's kick deep into Samoan half. Johnny Samuelo. Deegan. Chip and chase. Ball on the ground. And Samoa have it. That's Junior. Junior Halafuka. Fetalainga. Knocked down by the big prop Marco Fepalui, who's just come on. A lot of scrappy play with mishandling at the moment. Here's a replacement coming on for the Australians. Number 19, Lucan Lelalotto. He's a big man. Have a look at him. 123 kilos, 198 centimetres tall. He plays for Randwick. So Ned Haddingen off and Lelalotto in his place at lock. I thought Haddingen played very well, dominated the lineouts. Ioane. Tiatia. And the kick ahead. Newsom falling over, but regathered the ball and did very well there. Slippery part of the ground. This is James Tuttle. Strong. Yasmin comes into acting halfback. Ollie Camp takes it on. Back to Deegan to clear it. Yasmin coming through, but not with much pace. Plenty of time now. Taumatane gets it out to Tiatia. Good run here. No, that's Ioane. Ioane almost through the whole Australian side. Jack Redden's over there. He's under pressure, though. And it's a penalty to Samoa. Yeah. So this line out, 15 metres out from the Australian line. Junior Halafuku throwing in. Taken beautifully by Leavasa, but not in straight. Sixteen minutes left in this game. Australia right on top at 30 points to 5. And a couple of fresh reserves warming up in the sideline, among them Harry Nusifura. Interesting youngster, the youngest player at the tournament, just turned 18. Will go in at halfback, replacing James Tuttle. And he's a Bond University player, so the only representative from the local club. Also Aaron Pleish from Ipswich is going to come on, along with Tyson Davis. Not on the field yet. Tuttle feeds. Disrupted by the halfback Tamatani because the scrum wheeled. And good driving play here by Samoa. Very close to the line, going the pick and drive. It's there for Feta Leinga, can't make it. Ah, it's been lost, snapped up by the Australians. Well, that was close, wasn't it? Deegan's kick is a beauty, 50 metres gained. And very good stout defence right on their own line. I think it was Marco Fepulie who dropped the ball with the try line looming. So here's the replacements coming on, as I mentioned. Nusifura, Pleish and Davis. Nusifura in at halfback. Jack Redden coming off. Went close a couple of times to getting a birthday try, but he didn't get it. So Pleish going under the wing. And also Cameron Orr's come off. So here's Nusifura's first touch. Gets it out to Ned Hannigan. A strong run by him. Thought he'd gone off, but he seems to be back on. Tunnel McInerney makes a dart. Akasilia from Sunnybank Club. Deegan. Kellaway. Lovely swerve by Kellaway. Gets it away to Christian Yasmin. Lobs the pass back inside but can't find a support. It's a turn. Oh no, it's back to Australia. Wilkin. Now it's the big man, Lucan, who's going close. Leilai Lotto. And the ball goes to ground just with the try line in sight. From Johnny Samuelu, it goes back to the fullback Tia Tia, who kicks it and it bounces awkwardly, finally into touch for the quick throw in. Yasmin. That's Tyson Davis, number 23. And the penalty goes against the Australians. There's been a welter of penalties lately against the Australian team, losing their discipline. 12 minutes to go, 30 points to 5. So Tia Tia shaping to kick for the line, took the tap, wanting to go for the running option. Got support there. Johnny Samuelu, and look at this run down the sideline. It's going to be a try. Number 14 scores for Samoa. Caught the Australians napping. They're a bit lazy there, and it's Amu Tuema Leliafano. Tuima Laliafano, who scores the try. Fresh legs on for the Samoans. And that was terrific play by Tia Tia, the fullback, to take the tap kick when the Australians just turned their backs and relaxed momentarily.
Great try there for Samoa. It takes them, it's 30 points to 10. So it's scored by number 14,
30 points to 10. Lafano. You wonder if he's a relation of Christian Laliafano, but it's Tuima Laliafano. Showed a clean pair of heels, didn't he? That's the second try scored by the Samoans. This is Taumataini, who's having a shot. The halfback looking into the sun from right on the sideline. Out to the left. And so the score, Australia 30, Samoa 10. 10 minutes left.
Conversion unsuccessful. Score remains Australia 30, Samoa 10.
Falau Fangar is coming onto the field. One of the famous rugby family. There's three of them playing in Super Rugby in Australia. He's from Matraville High School, so he's probably a distant relation of the Queenslanders, and plays for Sydney University. He's a Garbo. Samoa buoyed by that try. Good racking. Comes back to the halfback, Taumataini. He has support there. A lovely little run made by the centre. Put through there. That was Parafilo. And kicked ahead, picked up by Deegan. And he's been very reliable today, Andrew Deegan. Especially in moments like that, when they're under a bit of pressure. His touch finders have been fantastic. But the Samoans' tactics of running the ball are working quite well against this tiring Australian pack. Their legs are getting weary, they're big guys. And that's good clean ball for Samoa. Out to Ioane. Number 8 out there is Jordan Jacket. They retain possession. Really flooding the breakdown, aren't they? That's Potu Leavasa. Deegan, a good tackle. Underneath big man Kome Samau. Penalty taken quickly. This seems to be the tactic to catch the Australians napping, because they're tiring. And quite understandably, Adrian Thompson has sent on some fresh legs. Harry Nusafora feeding this scrum on the Australian 22. His father Gary is head of sport here at Bond University. Picked up nicely by Nusafora onto Payayua. Nusafora spots a gap and is hit hard by a high tackle by Winterstein, but the referee said it was okay. So Samoa pushing up towards the 22 now. Strong one by Leavasa. That's Fetalainga. Tafili. Australians finding it hard to contain these men in blue shirts at the moment. But good pass by Nusifora back. And a penalty goes against the Australians at that breakdown. So the momentum of this match has really swung from Australia being dominant, as they were in the first half, to Samoa coming back strongly. But unfortunately for the Samoans, I think the clock's going to beat them. There's only 6 minutes left in the match. Milani Mataveo is on in number 21. He's the reserve halfback, replacing Tumatane. Tumatane's gone out to fly half, number 9. There he is. Long pass in the centre. That's Patafilo. Still keeping the ball alive. Good tackle made by Hannigan. A pick and drive now by the Samoans. They're looking for their third try here. They're close. Pass is disrupted. And picked up by the Australians, and play on, says the referee. Now Nusifora has a look, gets it out now to Killaway. Back inside to Nusifora. He's held by the jersey by Winterstein. Can't pass. Acting halfback McInerney. That's Ollie Camp. Plenty of pressure in the Samoan defence here. Deegan. Decides to have a bit of a run. He could have kicked. He's hurt his leg as he kicked. Back to Samau. Kome Samau is replacement fullback. That's a penalty. They didn't retreat well inside the 10 metres. At this stage of the game, nobody's retreating. Four minutes left. I think the Australians will be quite grateful when the full-time whistle blows, because it's been all the blues in the last few minutes. Throw into the back. Nicely pulled down by Ned Hannigan, who's got rid of the headgear now. He's been tremendous in the lineouts. Nusifora looks for a runner and finds it in the big fellow. Aluka. Now a chance. They've got a line here if they can control their passing. Ollie Camp has two men outside him. Yasmin, not going anywhere. The referee's whistle had already gone for a knock on. Three minutes left, four tries to two, 30 points to 10. I think the fly half, Andrew Deegan's got a bit of a leg problem. He's going down, stretching his thigh. Slipped over in the wet field and might have just strained a hamstring or something, but he's not looking to the physio for anything. Campbell Hansen. Might just be tired. He's had a pretty busy game, Andrew Deegan. Under 2 minutes till the full-time bell. And how lucky we are to have had this weather today after the torrential rain we had the previous couple of days, cyclonic conditions yesterday, 150 mils of water drenching the Gold Coast, and yet today, well, look at this. You couldn't ask for better conditions. So receiving treatment is Junior Halefuka, a replacement hooker. The try scorers for Australia, two tries to Christian Yasmin, one each to Lolo Fakasilia and Brad Wilkin. And the rest of the points came from the boot of Andrew Deegan, who's kicked 4 out of 6. For Samoa, their tries to Amu Tuima Leliafano and Trent Winterstein. Here's for waiting. It's Samoan feed. Good scrum. And the ball was left there. Anybody's. Doesn't quite find touch. That's Davis. Newsom. That's a pretty ordinary kick. I don't know why he kicked that. A chip and chase, that should be a penalty. Tackled in the air. The advantage, the arm is out. Deegan. Look at this run from Paiaua. Still got the step in the last minute of the match. Huh? Doesn't look like there's going to be a penalty. Yasmin looking for his third try. McInerney lost it. That was Winter. Riley Winter just went without it. Knocked on. Seconds left in this match. And what an exhibition of rugby we've seen, particularly from New Zealand today. They were the really impressive. Admittedly against a much weaker opposition. Japan making their first under-20s tour of Australia. Relative rookies. Samoa, of course, much more experienced and bigger and stronger. They've really put it up to the Australians in the second half and limited their scoring to 30 points to 10. Just a reminder, the next matches will be played on Tuesday, the 5th of May. First match at 1 p.m. local time, New Zealand against Samoa. And at 3 p.m. Australia will play Japan. And the final round will be played on Saturday week, the 9th of May, when Australia will play New Zealand and Samoa will play Japan. We hope you've enjoyed this coverage, this live stream on the rugby.com.au website. Wherever you're watching around the world, it's been a delight to be here today. I must say, I hope you've enjoyed the coverage. Seems to be a bit of concern over this Samoan player. The doctor's out there with him, and the physio, Josh Ioane. Dr. Stephen Freeman. The referee looking at his watch and perhaps thinking, well, I could blow full time now. There's only seconds left, but the referee, of course, is the sole judge of time. It's 1 minute 50, in fact, so there is a bit of time. It's the skipper, Josh Dowsing, who's played a terrific match for Samoa. He's got a neck injury. They quite wisely didn't want to move him until they gave him the clearance, but he's playing on gamely. Josh comes from Waikato University Club. So what could be the last scrum of the game? Who knows? Less than 2 minutes to play. Milani Matoveo feeds the scrum for Samoa. And look at that. What a tremendous shove by the Australians. That's a penalty right in front of the posts. What will they do here? The Samoans caught them half asleep when they scored their try from a tap penalty. And they raced 50 metres to score. But the Australians are going to have a shot for penalty goal. I think they've probably had enough. They're pretty weary. So it's Andrew Deegan who'll have the last shot for goal. He's been very impressive today. One of Australia's best players. He's kicked 4 from 6, 2 penalties and 2 conversions so far. And this might be all she wrote. The Bond University Rugby Club is based at this ground and they're doing very well in the competition in their second year in the Brisbane Premier Grade competition. And it's no wonder when you see facilities like this. Deegan raises the flags. It makes it 33 points to 10, his 5th successful kick out of 7 attempts. And we'll have time for one more play.
33-10, 10 seconds left on the clock.
Siren has sounded, a pretty lame sounding siren, but we could hear it. Might have been some plovers in the trees. There's the kickoff and a pretty poor play by the Australians. They just let that one go. Newsom kicks it out. And the referee says, that's it. No side, full time. And Australia has defeated Samoa 33 points to 10. But a very impressive comeback by the Samoans in the second half. 4 tries to 2 for Australia. 2 tries to their winger, Christian Yasmin, and 1 each to Lolo Fakasilia and Brad Wilkin. And the rest of the points.